Can you believe this? This solar tracker costs a whopping $3,000. In this video, I'll show you how to replicate a mini sun tracker for under 20 bucks. This circuit is designed to automatically align itself with sunlight. No matter how you adjust its direction, it may look complex at first glance, but building it is actually quite simple. You only need 7 basic components. Let's go through the step-by-step process of making this circuit. The control chip used here is the TDA2822. Although this chip is typically used as an amplifier, in this case, it functions as a voltage comparator. Pins 5 and 7, as well as pins 6 and 8 of the chip, need to be connected using wires. The inverting and non-inverting inputs of both operational amplifiers are connected in parallel. This ensures that during operation, the outputs of these two operational amplifiers will be opposite. Next, we need a 10 coulomb 1/4 watt resistor, which we connect between pin 5 and pin 4 of the chip. This resistor serves as the lower voltage divider resistor for pin 5. Another 10 coulomb resistor is required as the upper voltage divider resistor for pin 5, which we connect between pin 2 and pin 5. Now, we introduce 2 photoresistors, which serve as the upper and lower voltage divider resistors for pin 8. Unlike the fixed resistors, these photoresistors adjust their resistance based on light intensity. This allows the circuit to respond dynamically to changes in light levels. A small DC motor, 130 model, is used to drive movement, operating at 3 to 9 volts DC. The motor's positive terminal connects to pin 1 of the chip, while the negative terminal connects to pin 3. With this setup, the operational amplifiers control the motor's forward and reverse rotation. For power, a 3.7 volt lithium battery is used, and it should have a protection board. The battery's positive terminal connects to pin 2, VCC, of the chip, and the negative terminal connects to pin 4. Additionally, a 5-volt solar panel can be integrated to charge the lithium battery. The solar panel's output terminals should be connected in parallel with the battery terminals. Here I made a mistake. The positive terminal should be connected to pin 2 instead of pin 1. For added convenience, a self-locking switch can be installed in the power supply line. When the circuit is not in use for extended periods, this switch allows for easy power disconnection. Once everything is set up, the solar tracking circuit is complete. Now, let's assemble the components. A base is attached to the motor shaft so that the circuit's direction can change as the motor rotates. After assembly, it's time for testing. As we move the light source, the circuit automatically follows it. Here is the circuit diagram for reference. Its working principle is straightforward. The two 10 kilo ohm resistors provide a fixed resistance, ensuring that the voltage at pins 5 and 7 of the chip remains at half of VCC. However, the resistors connected to pins 6 and 8 are photoresistors, which change resistance based on light intensity. The stronger the light, the lower the resistance of the photoresistor. If the left photoresistor receives more light, pin 1 of the chip outputs a high voltage, and pin 3 outputs a low voltage. This makes the motor rotate forward. Conversely, if the right photoresistor receives more light, pin 1 outputs a low voltage, and pin 3 outputs a high voltage. This causes the motor to rotate in the opposite direction. Thanks for watching. That's all for this demonstration. If you find this project interesting, you can try building it yourself.